got a very glamorous, thank God you're here, curtain for you.
Okay, so I'm coming through the back door. My preferred way to enter.
Must be your birthday. All right. Oh. Marty Sheargold. Good luck.
Thank you.
Oh. Thank God you're here. We're just about to roll tape.
All right, let's go. Jared, and this is...
Hey, guys, I'm Tommy, and I'm new, like you. Sometimes it's fun to be new, isn't it, guys?
I think Tommy is being a bit silly. It's our friend Nathan.
Oh, it is too! I was being silly. You're right, I absolutely was.
Now, we've got a super exciting show coming up. I'm going to be teaching everyone a new dance.
I've got a special recipe for yummy biscuits.
And what will you be showing the children, Nathan?
I'm going to turn an orange juice bottle into a bomb. I'm joking. I'm joking. I'm joking. I am going to be painting something with a potato.
So happy! Let's show everyone our happy faces. Jared, Tina, and Nathan.
But now we've got some really, really sad news about Bubbles. What happened to Bubbles, Nathan?
I got one of those calcium feeders, and when I put it in, I didn't realise you had to take it out of the plastic. So the poor thing's eaten plastic instead of the actual calcium feeder, which was supposed to last 2 weeks.
Nathan, when we came in this morning to feed Bubbles, he was lying on his back with his eyes closed. What was wrong with him?
He was having parent time.
But we do have some good news. Nathan has written a special song about Bubbles.
Yes!
Ready, Mr. Music?
Nathan.
Oh, hopefully it's someone with a drink.
Oh, it's Cheeky Monkey.
It is.
Wow. Hi, Nathan. Oh, why don't we tell the boys and girls all about the naughty thing that we did together?
Cheeky Monkey's joking.
We know what happens to children who are naughty.
We do. They go to the naughty children's home.
Nathan, it's the clock chiming, and we all know what that means.
We have a smoker.
It's story time!
Yes!
Oh, I'm down too.
Once upon a time,
okay,
there were three rabbits. Big rabbit, little rabbit, and...
medium rabbit.
The three rabbits lived in a cozy burrow where there was one thing they loved doing more than anything else.
Making other rabbits?
But one day, little rabbit said something so mean to the other rabbits. What did he say, Nathan?
You got buck teeth.
This made the other rabbits so sad that they wanted to do what? They wanted to...
be part of a ragu.
They wanted to run away.
Yes,
and hide.
Of course.
And someone's being mean to children. What should they do?
They should punch them in the face.
Well, it's time for us to go.
Oh.
So, until next time on... on Kids Corner, Big Rabbit says...
See you later.
Little Rabbit says...
Catch you soon.
And Medium Rabbit says...
Sorry.
Just as a special, super special welcome back gift...
Oh, yeah.
..we've got a bit of company for you.
Do you really?
Yes, we do.
Yeah, I knew it.
Thank God you're here.
Babe. Oh, I missed you, babe. Where have you been, babe?
Not here. Yeah.
Oh, hello.
They're saying there's some issues with our luggage. What do you think
me?
It would be?
Well, obviously that's got to be all your equipment.
We have a very active sex life and we've been away, haven't we? We've been away and we like to have a little bit of fun, just the two of us, and they might be batteries, lithium batteries. I'm sorry, take them out.
Mrs. Henty.
Mrs. Henty? Oh. It's so great hearing my name now that we're married. Mrs. Henty.
We've got a few questions about your passenger declaration form. Yes. Can you tell us what was the reason for your trip to Bali?
Our trip to Bali was to get married.
Well, you've ticked business, so what...
I did that as a tax deduction. We did get married for business and it was amazing.
And then you went to Central America? Why Central America?
My wife's family are actually from Colombia. What's the name of the town again?
Bogota.
We actually found 3 mink coats.
Yes.
With the tags still on them.
Did you?
In your suitcase.
Right.
Why do you need 3 mink coats for Central America?
Because I was going to sell them for some more toys for our love life.
We've also found this boogie board cover. What's inside it, Mrs. Henty?
That's a very soft boogie board, isn't it? That it doesn't feel like a real board. Listen, we are on a really important trip for the Australian government. We've been to Bogota and we've been hiding as a married couple undercover and, by God, I mean, I didn't want to fall in love with you, but I have. But we are an important business and it's no business of yours because we are here on a higher order, are we not, Trevor?
Our sniffer dog here, Mrs. Henty, seems to be very interested in you. I'm
very good with animals. He can feel my auras, I'm sure.
This box over here, it's marked fragile. Can you tell us what's fragile in there?
What is fragile in there? Hello. Oh. Oh, my God. Well, that, Trevor.
Mrs. Henty?
Yes.
Why is there a snake in your luggage?
Wow, that is a real snake. A real snake is in my luggage because that poor thing was going to be abandoned in Bogota and we wanted to bring it back. Save it because we care. I mean, this used to be an animal and we saved it. We're taking it back to its family. That's real.
Would you mind telling us what's inside your handbag?
I would think there would be normal things, like possibly a pair of socks from the flight and some pyjamas.
Would you mind showing me the contents of the bag, please?
Of course I would, yes. It'd be my pleasure. Love to do that.
What? What are we looking at here?
Well, that's a wallet and that's some stuff.
Mrs. Henty, before we conduct a full body search, we are going to need you to step into our 3D scanner. Now, is there any reason you won't be able to comply with this request?
Well, if it sends me to jail, probably not, but all right, yes. I mean, you've done very little, that's all I'm saying.
Very well.
I thought we had something. I really did.
If you could step in, Mrs.
Henty. Yes, I know
please.
How.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, I mean, honestly. I mean, you haven't even asked me to take this off. And that is not a real animal. Take these off as well. That would be one as well. Can we not just live our lives?
Thank you, Mrs. Henty. Just scanning. Wonderful. You may step out, Mrs. Henty. Thank you. You can join your husband over there.
Oh, can I?
Mrs. Henty, what are we looking at there?
Oh. We're pregnant. With watches. That's unusual. That is very unusual. Look, you made me swallow four watches. Eat them, but you said one watch, two watch, three watch, bang, tick, 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 and now I am literally a ticking time bomb.
Guy Montgomery, welcome back to the show. See you on the other side.
Okay, thank you. Good luck, Guy. All right.
Thank God you're here. There's a gentleman over there. He says he's got a meeting with you.
Yeah, that sounds about right. I run a lot of meetings in this joint.
May I present Mr. Rick Stern, the owner of this establishment?
Hello, the name's Rick Stern. I'm the owner of this establishment. Don't leave a man hanging.
So you're the owner of Rosie's Bar. Obvious question, who's Rosie?
Well, Rosie's more of a concept than a person. My first wet dream was with a woman called Rosie.
Quite a place you got here, Stern. I look around, all I see are fugitives, criminals, reprobates. What brings them here?
Well, we got a good vibe going on.
I'll cut to the chase.
Okay.
I want to buy your place.
Oh, wow. You were just trashing this place. You were telling me there were reprobates and whatnot, and now you want in. I'm having the craziest day.
How does $5,000 sound?
Well, it would depend what year we're in.
Let me set you straight. You're going to have to offer more than just money.
Yeah. Wow. So, I don't know. My cat died. You got any cats?
My offer stands until midnight. You know where to find me, don't you?
Yeah, under the bridge.
Take care, Stern.
You take care. It's a dangerous bridge.
Now, there's a woman over there that's looking at you.
Okay.
Why would she be looking at you?
Have you seen what I'm wearing?
How do you do it? What is it about you that women find so irresistible?
I suppose it's a combination of things. I'm very grateful for my upbringing. My parents instilled a great sense of work ethic. You know, it's an interesting question, isn't it? Where does charisma come from?
So, Rick, we meet again.
Yeah.
The last time we met, where was it?
It was above the bridge.
It was Paris.
Oh,
just
yes.
Just before the war.
Yeah, the war, man! Shit, that went on and on. And I was against it. You know, I wrote a letter.
What is it that the French say? Plus ça change, plus.
Yeah, they say plus, do you say, the more things change, the more they stay the same. But they do it in that funny little voice they have.
So what's a girl got to do to get a drink around here?
Well, the bar's literally within arm's reach. Oh, this'll be us.
Mr. Stern, your usual.
Yeah.
Oh, two what drinks. Is your usual?
Oh, you want to know what's in there? Yeah, it's hard to say. It looks a bit like a Negroni. I'm going to call it a Negroni.
It's a flaming hairball.
Oh, yes.
That's what is it, a flaming hairball?
Well, it's Italian for Negroni. I think that's real alcohol.
And of course, champagne.
Champagne! Oh! What are we celebrating?
I mean, the war's over for a start. And it looks like I could be getting a new cat. I don't mean to be disrespectful, but who the hell was that guy?
How about a song?
Sounds good.
Any requests?
Play our song. Join me, Rick.
Of course.
Oh my gosh, it's a lovely day for you and I
to walk in the park. And we're still in the park.
Stop that singing now.
Oh my gosh. Thank God you're here.
Rick, you've gone too far this time.
What have you done?
Well, I've gone too far.
I got your paperwork right here.
Oh, dear.
Why don't you tell them what you've been doing in that back room?
I don't really know what it's called in this era, but I believe eventually we'll know it as methamphetamine.
Smuggled goods, tobacco, firearms.
Yeah.
And what else?
Yeah, there was the tobacco, there was the firearm, there were the cutlasses. I did overinvest. I thought the cutlasses were going to come back. But once you got guns, you don't really need a cutlass. I am humiliated by the sheer volume of cutlasses I have. I can't even sell them to pirates, you know. I'm a laughing stock of the weapons trade.
You're coming with me, Rick.
Where are we going to go?
Unless you give me one good reason why I shouldn't arrest you now.
I reckon I'm going to get off with this lady.
Welcome to the show.
All right.
Your world awaits.
All right. Oh, thank God you're here.
Oh.
Our new guests have just arrived at the resort.
It's always me. Why can you not do it? You're the concierge. What does this mean?
Welcome to
Hub. Welcome to. Do you need me? Oh, thank God you're here, but now you do it. All right, you welcome me.
Welcome to Harmony Sands. May we present the resort manager, Miss Clifton. She'll be happy to answer any questions you may have.
Hello. How are you?
Yeah.
Welcome.
Well, look, can I just start
welcome
with the.
To you. Aren't you a couple or is this a. Father-daughter thing, what is just so we're clear.
All right, OK, let's start with an obvious question. Let's start with an obvious question.
I think I did, but that's...
We have been waiting here for half an hour. What is the hold-up?
Well...
Miss Clifton.
I wasn't here. I mean, obviously, had I been here, you wouldn't have been held up, so I am putting it to you. Answer the question or you won't be here tomorrow. Oh, hey, hey.
They also said there was a small problem with our accommodation. What was wrong with our rooms?
Again, is anyone aware that I wasn't here? It feels like everyone's missing that point. Tell me what the problem is and I'll fix it. I mean, I will fix it for you. Because at Harmony Sands, we welcome people. In harmony to the sands.
And we trust you're enjoying your complimentary welcome cocktails?
Sort of. What was in it?
Guava.
Hang on. I'm going to say a little bit of cotties. A bit of my dad picks the fruit. And did you want alcohol or not want alcohol? Because again, I'm not sure how old you are. Can you be drinking? Do you think we look the same? I think we're a little similar.
Miss Clifton.
Now let's start by issuing you both with these wristbands. The green band indicates that all meals are included.
And what does the red band indicate?
I think you know.
You can go to the bar.
It says here that we're entitled to a honeymoon breakfast. What's in the honeymoon breakfast?
Oh, I'm going to start with eggs. Any way you want them. Bacon. What else do you need? See, I feel like I'm bringing them round. They were angry when I arrived, but look at the faces now.
Yes, yes, Miss Clinton.
That's why I'm the manager. You're the concierge and you're nothing.
Now, activities, we have sailing, horse riding, kayaks, or if you're really adventurous...
We're doing a key party.
We were sort of hoping to just relax.
Then why not try a massage? We recommend our signature treatment, spa
fusion. Oh, sorry, I just noticed we've got a couple of other guests. How are you? That's me.
Miss Clifton.
What are you drinking? that's what you want. That's nice. You'll like that one. There we go. Let's take this.
Miss Clifton.
Yes. All right. Cheers.
Take care of your bags.
How do we tip him?
How do you tip him?
Yeah.
Give the money to me and I'll pass it on.
We've got your welcome pack, scented candles, complimentary chocolates, and to help spice up your evening...
Your best friend, Miss Clifton. I'm the thing that's gonna spice up your evening. That's the big surprise. And how many things?